So in this video, we'll be learning about leveling and we'll be solving a particular numerical using height of instrument method and rise and fall method. And we'll be solving this in Excel. And at the end of this video, I'll be also giving you a formula for Excel, which you can implement if there are a large number of points. Okay. So basically, the leveling is done using a dummy level and a vertical staff. So from the dummy level, you sight the staff, and whatever reading you get, that is basically the level that we record in the record book. Okay, and the staff is, as you might be knowing, this is maximum 4 meter height. Okay, so let's just straight away get to the numerical. So let us say that we have this kind of strata. So first of all, why do we do actually this leveling? The leveling is done to understand what kind of ground we have for the survey. And to understand what kind of ground we have, we need to know what are the height, or what is the variation of the height or variation of the topography of that particular survey area. So for this purpose, what we do is that we put a long chain, a 30 meter chain, or so in a straight line we put a chain, and on that chain we mark certain points. Okay, and for those points we need to find the level, and this level is found from a base point or from a reference point. This reference point is what we call as a benchmark. So benchmark would be a point whose RL, or the reduced level, or the height of that point is already known to us. So this height could be, either you take this height from the mean sea level, so that would be the actual height of that point, or this height could be anything that you give. Okay, that would be a reference point, and from that reference point, based on that reference point, all other heights would be determined. So in our case, let us say this point one is the benchmark. Okay, and this benchmark is having a height of 100. So this height I already know. Okay, so I need to find the heights of all these points that are marked. So for that, what I'll do is, I'll first set up my station or the instrument here. That is, this is the dummy level that I've set up, and I'll be employing a staff, a vertical staff. The first vertical staff will always be on the reference point, because you need to know that what is your position with respect to the reference point. Okay, so that first reading that you'll be taking is on the reference point or on the benchmark, and let us say, and this first reading that you take, that would be called as a backside reading. Now why it is called as backside? Because the progress of our survey is in this direction. This is the forward side, this is the forward direction of our survey, and anything that we take behind would be called as a backside. Okay, so the first reading would always be this backside, and let us say that I get a reading of 2 on this vertical staff. Okay, then after that, I keep my vertical staff on the second point. I'll be keeping it here, and I'll be now noting the reading in the direction of my travel, or in the direction of the survey. So this reading that I get, let us say I get a reading of 2.6 here. After the second point, you will be keeping your vertical staff on point 3. Okay, and again from the same point where you are there, from that same point you will be taking a reading. Let us say that this reading is 3.2, and after that I'll be putting my vertical staff at 4. Okay, at this point, and from the same station where you are located, you will sight this fourth point. Okay, so basically what you need to do is that you need to keep on shifting your vertical staff till a point reaches that you cannot further see your vertical staff. So you can see that here at point number 4, I have already reached the topmost part of this vertical staff, right? Let us say that this height is 3.9, and we know that the vertical staff is almost 4 meters. right? So this should be a final reading, because from this point you won't be able to take readings further, correct? So this should be a final reading from this point. Let us say this point is A. From point A, this is the final reading. So the final reading that you take, that is named as foresight. You remember we had named something as backsight. So backsight would always be your first reading. Foresight will always be your last reading from a single point, from the station from which you are taking the readings. And all other readings are known as intermediate sight. Okay. After this, to take further readings, I necessarily have to shift my station. So let us say that I keep my dumpy level here. And the first reading from this that we are taking in the backward direction would be your backside reading. And let us say that that reading is 0.8. This is my backside reading. Then I put my vertical staff on fifth position, and we get a reading of here as, let us say it is 1.4. Can we further shift this vertical staff? Yes, we can do that. So this is not the final reading. We can further shift our staff. And let us say that the reading that you get here is 2 meters, right? So this is an intermediate site. This is also an intermediate site. Just a minute. So this would be intermediate site. This is also intermediate site. Let us further shift our vertical staff to point number 7. And we can still see that point number 7. So we should not change our position. Here it is 2.8, let us say. This would also be an intermediate site. Then at point number 8, see, your line of sight will always remain horizontal. Okay, the line of sight never deviates. That should always be horizontal. And here let us say that this is 2.1. Okay, so this would be 2.1, let us say. Now if I keep let us say that this is the last reading that I want to take, and for taking the reading of 9 and 10 onwards, I want to shift my location. So if this is the last reading that I'm taking from this position, then this would be my foresight, correct? Let us say that this position is B. Let us use some other pen for this. This is A and this is B. So this is the foresight. Now let me move my station to a point somewhere here. Okay. So the first reading that I'll be taking from this point would be a backward reading, backside reading. And let us say that that is 3.1. It's a backside reading. Okay. Then I keep my vertical staff on 0.9. I take a forward reading ahead. That would be, let us say it is 0.9. Okay. Now, can I shift this vertical staff on 10? No, I won't be able to see it. Therefore, this should be the final reading from this point, right? So this is your foresight. And this is, let us say it is point C. This is point C. Then I move my station to the next point, which would be this point here. And the first reading that I'll be taking is the backside reading on 0.9. Let us say that that reading is 3 meters. It's a backside. I shift my vertical staff. And I take the reading. This should be the last reading from this position, because 11, point number 11, I won't be able to sight. So let us say that this I am getting a value of 1.2, and this is, since this is the last reading, it should be named as foresight. This is your point D. Let us move to the next, because now I'll have to shift my position. Okay, the first reading that I'll be taking from this point is the backside reading on number 10, and that is, let us say that we are getting a value of 2.4 backside, correct? And once I shift my vertical staff on point 11, this would be the final reading that I'll be getting, and let us say that the reading that I get here is 0.8. So this is your foresight. Okay, so this completes the events of taking readings on different points, and you see that wherever we are not able to take the reading, then we have to shift the point, right? So now whatever data that you have gathered here, you have to log it into a particular manner that we call as record book, okay, or the leveling book, and in that we follow a particular manner, and in that we find what are the heights of these various points. So this we'll be doing in Excel, and we'll be doing it by both the methods, height of instrument method and the rise and fall method. So let us move to Excel now. Let me just arrange the windows. So this first thing that we are doing here is by the height of instrument method. Okay, so we have all these points from 1 to 11. Okay, then this first column is backside, second is intermediate side, third is foresight, fourth is height of instrument HI, and fifth is RL. Okay, so first point is our benchmark point, and I already know the RL of that point, which is 100, so I'll directly put 100 here. Okay, and then we just have to log in whatever readings that we have taken. So on point number one, have we taken any reading? Yes, we have taken a backside reading, right? It is of 2 meters. Then any other reading on that point? No. On point number two, have we taken reading? Yes, intermediate side reading is there, 2.6. No other reading. On point three, 3.2 intermediate side. On point four, we have a foresight reading of 3.9. Yes, a foresight reading of 3.9. And any other reading on this point number 4? We have a backside reading of 0.8. Correct? We have a backside reading of 0.8. First, let us just log in all the details and then we'll find the RL. Okay. Then here in this ahead of 0.4, we have 0.5, where on 0.5 we have an intermediate side reading of 1.4, then no other reading. On 0.6 we have an intermediate reading of 0.2, 2 meters. Then 7 we have intermediate side of 2.8. On point number 8 we have a foresight of 2.1, and also have a backside of 3.1. Okay. Then on point 9 we have a foresight of 0.9 and a backside of 3 meters, right? A backside of 3 meters on same point. Then we on point number 10 we have a foresight of 1.2 and a backside of 2.4. So 1.2 foresight, 2.4 backside. On point 11, we have a foresight of 0.8. So we have logged in all the details. Now let us find the reduced levels of all other points. We know the reduced level of point 1, which is 100. So if I know this 100, can I find the height of this instrument? How should I find the height of instrument? It should be 100 plus 2, right? This this 100 plus 2 meters will give me the height of this instrument. It's not actually the height of instrument, but it is actually the height of line of sight. This is called as line of sight. Okay, so the height of the instrument here is, it is equal to 100 plus 2, which is 102. Okay, and now I want to find the heights of these points. So if I know the height of my line of sight, if this line of sight is having a height of 102, then this point number 2 will be, this is 102, 102 minus 2.6 will give me this point, because this much is 2.6, right? So 102 minus 2.6 will give me the RL of point number 2. So 102 minus this intermediate side. Okay, so every time if I want to find the height of point 3, that will be 102 minus 3.2, because this much is 3.2. So it is height of instrument minus 3.2, that is 98.8. We come to point number 4, which is 102 minus 3.9. So it is 102 minus 3.9, which is 98.1. Okay, so I got the height of this point number 4, which is at 98.1. Now I have changed my instrument here. Again, I'll have to find the height of this line of sight. So what should be the height of this line of sight? That will be 98.1 plus 0.8. This is 0.8, right? So this line of sight will be 98.1 plus 0.8. So you see, there is a pattern for this height of instrument. There would be a formula for this height of instrument. That formula should be RL plus backside. That would be the formula, RL plus backside. And all other points would be height of instrument minus intermediate side or foreside, any one of them, right? All these RLs would be height of instrument minus intermediate side minus foreside. So again, here I have found the new height of instrument. So now the height of this 0.5 will be, this is 98.9, right? 98.9 minus 1.4 will be the height of point number 5. So it is 98.9 minus 1.4. Then we come to point 6, which is 98.9 minus 2, height of instrument minus this. Then point 7 will be 98.9 minus 2.8. Point number 8 will be 98.9 minus 2.1. Okay, and after 0.8, I shift my instrument. So again, I'll have to find the height of the instrument. And for 0.8, I already know the height is 96.8. So I will have to find the height of this line of sight, which is 96.8 plus 3.1, right? So that will be 96.8 plus 3.1, 99.9. So now this is having a height of 99.9, and the point number 9 will be 99.9 minus 0.9. So this will be 99.9 minus 0.9. I got this to be 99. Then again I am shifting, so I'll have to find the height of this line of sight, which will be 99 plus 3. So it is 99 plus 3, which is 102. So this is 102. Then point number 10 will be 102 minus 1.2. 102 minus 1.2. So I got this height to be 100.8. Again, I shifted my instrument, so I'll need to find the height of this line of sight, which is 100.8 plus 2.4. So it is 100.8 plus 2.4. Okay, it is 103.2. And this is 103.2, and for 0.11 it will be 103.2 minus 0.8. So it is 103.2 minus 0.8, which is 102.4. So this is the final height. So we have found the heights of all the points, and thus this completes the survey, at least the leveling. This is by height of instrument method. I told you that we also have one more method, which is rise and fall method. Rise and fall method is equally easy. So now I'll be just using this data, and let us say that this is for the rise and fall method. Okay, so let me use this data, backside, intermediate side and foreside. That's it. This is only data that we need, and the RL, of course, 100 would be the RL of the first point. So what this rise and fall says, that if you do previous reading, previous minus next, if you do this previous minus next, then whatever answer that you will be getting, if that is negative, it is a fall. If that answer is positive, it is a rise. So your previous minus next is, this is previous reading, 2 is the previous reading, 2.6 is the next reading. So 2 minus 2.6 is a negative, so it should come in fall, right? This 2 minus 2.6. You see, you are getting negative. So that, if you are getting the reading as negative, you should put it in the fall. If the reading is positive, you should put it in rise. Now previous minus next, so 2.6 minus 3.2, again you will be getting a negative reading. You should put that in fall, 2.6 minus 3.2, right? So why it is called as fall? You can see here that previous minus next, this is the previous reading, this is the next reading. 2 minus 2.6, I am getting minus 0.6, and you can see that this 0.2 is actually lower than 0.1. So yes, there is a fall of 0.6 meters. From 0.1 to 0.2, there is a fall of 0.6 meters. Again, 2.6 minus 3.2, we are getting minus 0.6. So you can see that this third point is lower than your second point. Therefore, it is a fall. And that is what we are simply putting in this method. Now, previous minus next, that is 3.2 minus 3.9. Again, that will be a negative reading, 3.2 minus 3.9, that's a minus 0.7, okay. Then we have, then we shift the station, and now the previous reading is 0.8, the next reading is 1.4. So 0.8 minus 1.4, again a negative reading, correct. 1.4 minus 2 is again a negative, so it will be put in the fall. 2 minus 2.8, again negative, so again in fall. 2.8 minus 2.1, this has to be positive, and that will be put in rise. So 2.8 minus 2.1 is plus 0.7, and it will go in the rise column. Then previous minus next is 3.1 minus 0.9, again a positive reading, that will go in rise. 3 minus 1.2, again positive, 3 minus 1.2, 2.4 minus 0.8 is again positive, right? Now what you need to do is, you need to simply keep on adding, like this will be 100 plus negative of 0.6, so that will be 99.4. See, the RL we are getting same, 99.4. Then this will be 99.4 plus this reading plus the reading of fall, which is negative, that is 98.8. Then 98.8 plus this point minus 0.7 will give you 98.1. Okay, so this is what we need to keep on doing. See, till this 0.7 we are getting the reading 96.1. to be correct. Then it will be 96.1 plus this rise which is there, 96.8, then this plus this, this plus this, and this plus this, 102.4. So all the reduced levels we have found. This was the rise and fall method. Now what if, now these are just 11 points, but what if you have 200 points or 300 points? Okay, so in such circumstances, what are you going to do? You cannot keep on checking that whether this previous minus next is going to be a positive number or it is going to be a negative number, or should I put it in fall or should I put it in rise. That is not what you are going to keep on doing, because that will consume a lot of time. So what should we do in such scenarios? I'll be teaching you a short formula that you can actually perform for large number of calculations. See, what essentially we are doing in calculating this rise and fall is, first what we did backside minus intermediate side. So this is one of the calculations that we are performing. Sorry, I'll write it here. This is one of the calculations that we are performing, backside minus intermediate side, right? Then we are performing intermediate side minus intermediate side, right? This minus this also we did. Then we did intermediate side minus four side here, correct? So intermediate side minus four side we did, intermediate side minus intermediate side, intermediate side minus four side, this is what we did. And there was one more calculation that we did, which was backside minus four side. See here, 3.1 minus 0.9, previous minus initial. So it was backside minus four side. These four operations are what we have performed to find the rise and fall. Knowingly and unknowingly, these are the four operations that we've performed. So I'll be writing here a formula. Same formula we'll be using for all these four operations. So see, it is if statement I'm using, and inside if statement the logical test will be OR. You might have learned this in logic. What is the logic of OR? So OR says that I'm performing backside minus initial side. Okay, so what I'll tell Excel is that if this value is nothing, for example here for second and third point, the backside value is nothing, right? If this value is nothing, or if this value is also nothing, then you don't do anything. This is what I'm telling to Excel. Then you don't perform any operation, or basically you just give me a zero value. Or else, if those values are present, then you do backside minus this initial side. So I get a negative 0.6. Okay, same way I'll do for BS minus FS also. I'll just copy this formula and I'll paste it here. But here I am talking about backside minus foreside. So I'll just shift this from intermediate side to foreside. That's it. And that is the only thing that I have to do. Okay, this will directly give me zero, because foreside I am having nothing there. And that is what I have told Excel, that if backside is nothing or if foreside is nothing, you give me zero. So the Excel is giving me zero. Again, I'll copy this formula. I'll put it here. So it is intermediate side minus intermediate side. So I'll just shift everything to intermediate side and intermediate side. Okay. So here it is giving me zero because this first point is zero. I'll again copy the formula and I'll put it here. This is intermediate side minus foreside. So intermediate side minus foreside. Again, it will give me zero. This thing, whole thing you select and you drag it down till this point. Okay. You will be getting all the rise and falls automatically. Now what you do is one more column you have to make here. It is sum of all these values. That's it. So sum of all these values, you will be getting this month table here. Okay, now I'll just delete this, and what I'll do is I'll tell Excel that if this value is greater than 0, just a minute, if this value is greater than 0, then you give me this value only. That is what rise means, right? Rise is greater than 0. But if it is not greater than 0, then you give me a 0 value there. So it will give me 0. Okay, let me just delete all these also. And I'll just drag this down. So you see all these points I got 0 because there was a fall there. And only these points I got correct. Okay, in the fall, I'll write if this value is less than 0, then you give me this value. Otherwise, you give me 0. Okay, so again, I'll drag this down. So I got my rise and fall. This is what you can do if you have n number of points. Okay, your life will become very easier. And now 100, I'll do this 100 plus rise plus fall. Why I did this? Because see, rise is obviously 0. So it is actually going to be 100 minus 0.6 at the end. I got 99.4. I drag this down. I got all the RLs till 102.4. Right? So this is a trick that you can use. Obviously, whatever, if you are very good in Excel, then whatever I have done here, you can just simply put everything in one single formula. But I did not do this because it might just confuse you. That formula would be a very big formula. And if you are really good in Excel, you can always try that. Okay. So that's it for this lecture. Till then, take care. Thank you.